Right, some things in this bag I don't need, like my work gloves when I go to work. Let's see what I do need. I don't need my working knife either.
Oh, hello there.
How you been recently? I'm just trying to sort out my bag because I think about going for a nice walk today in my bamboo boxers because I have a new mystery. And no, it's not that. I think the naughty tree has been a curse or something to me. I believe the magic windmill keeps happening over and over and over again because of that naughty tree. But I don't think it is exactly where the naughty tree is. Maybe it might be somewhere else that this curse is occurring. I'm alright, it's just... I know I solved the mystery of the creepy voice being Google. Now I don't know where Daniel is still. But I've always wanted to wonder recently, why does the magic windmill keep hearing and happening? Do you know why? My suspect is that the naughty tree is bothering me over and over again, but I didn't really think about it too much. I say, I am still disappointed at that. And no, don't worry, I haven't cut that tree down from the last vlog. I was trying to make you smile, which I likely did. I'm going to right now, going to change my pants and socks into, like, walking clothing because I'm wearing normal pants and I'm wearing socks that's got holes or the material's becoming worn and out. I might get blisters if I walk in them for a long time period. I'm going to get myself a drink and a snack and then we're going to try and find this curse about the magic windmill by the naughty tree. You should come along with me. Come on. Alright, let's see. So, about this magic windmill curse and the naughty tree. Maybe it's somewhere around here. I didn't hear anything the last time when I came here. Notice it's not Teletubby Land before you say anything. Okay, let me ask you this once. Does this look like anything like Teletubby Land? No, it doesn't, because it isn't, I'm afraid. But the curse could be occurring somewhere around here. Just need to have a good think first. Which way should I go? I'm gonna go that way. I haven't got really far, so I need to keep looking to find any ideas in my head. Sometimes if I look around, it gives me time to contemplate of ideas and thoughts of what could be true as facts. Do you think the curse could be around that corner? You don't know? Well, let's go and have a look and find out. I need to go further. I know you're probably thinking it sounds a bit scary, but I'm here, you know, you're not on your own. But I don't know why I keep going through these curses and mysteries and theories. It's like I've done something wrong to the real world. I don't know. Well, better not give up and just try again, I suppose the old saying goes. Come on. Thank you.
looks like an interesting path.
It goes up towards that tree. There's one path going that way, and this one going that way.
Could this be where the curse could be?
I don't know.
I'll investigate. I don't really think this is it, I don't think.
There's just so many branches and
wood. And I don't think the curse is here. Nah, I better keep searching.
But I did have a good thought though.
What about down in this path? Could the curse be around here? Let's have a look. We have two paths here. We got one for that way, and one that way. And I've also seemed to notice there's a rope up there.
I wonder if that's a clue, I wonder.
This is getting serious. We better keep quiet because if anything mysterious happens, I could be in serious trouble, and we don't want that now. I'm going to quietly investigate around here for any Ogoros if the magic windmill comes. Come on. Savers. Let's go this way. Where the curse is. Rumours have it is that if anyone touches that tree, the magic windmill will come and get you. I wonder if that fact is true. I know I'm supposed to be quiet, but I believe this is it. I just need to test it now. I was completely incorrect. Nothing happens. I am pathetic, you know, absolutely pathetic. Should have gone to Super Spec Savers. You know what? I give up. There's the magic windmill.
It's sounded.
Yeah.
that other tree I just touched like a minute ago, and then it sounds whenever it feels like it. So now we know about the truth of the magic windmill and the naughty tree and the curse. We found our clues. What am I gonna do now? Well, I think I'll keep all those theories in my mind, and I'm going to probably go do more walking, and then probably head home for myself and keep those theories in my mind. Well, I'll go in and go for my lovely walk. I'll carry on with it. What will you see what the other guys are doing, and I'll catch you up in a bit.
Are you struggling for dinner? Do you want a takeaway that's super easy to order and have it delivered? Well, ladies and gentlemen, I have something special that can help your problem to be solved. I have never heard of a guy called Justin Fletcher, but apparently he has something to do with something special. I have no clue. Anyways, Prashant's path will be opening on the 15th of May 2021 as not only a business for the public, but also an Indian fast food chain similar to McDonald's, Burger King, Nando's and many other popular companies. Just Eat for some reason will not let my business run on their career. I am bloody disappointed in them for blocking my path to victory into a reality plan. But anyways, never mind what I have to say about Just Eat, this is what Prashant's path has got to show the United Kingdom. You can order any curries or rices for £3.54 if you get 3 or more within a family meal. And, if you even get both, 3 curries and 3 rices, then you can get a 50% discount off from the normal total price. You can choose the big Indian family meal for under £10 with 5 curries, 5 rices, 3 sauces and you get pasta crackers for free along within the deal meal. KFC, don't you dare lawsuit on me because I'm using the deal meal slogan. I can do whatever I like, thank you very much. Again, the audience, business bits. Oi you. Don't you dare order anything on Just Eat. I can see you ordering Pizza Hut. Prashant's path has got so many meals and interesting deals you may be interested of investing. Please order today on 999. I said, 999. Oi you. Get off Just Eat right now before I use my super magical force field to give you a slappy whoppy and send you and possibly your family to boot camp and death sentence on the electric chair.
Whoa, Prashant. Hang on a minute. There are a few things wrong with your advert.
First of all, you cannot use 999 as your phone line. 999 is used for the emergency services and people should only call them if there is a serious case like a fire or a crime or an injury.
Secondly, you cannot fret the audience as it's their own decision of what takeaway they fancy ordering. You cannot expect everyone to order your company all the time.
And you cannot talk to KFC directly on an advert as advertisements are supposed to stay within the subject of the current advert only. It's a good thing this wasn't a displayable advert as you could have gotten into serious trouble with the police. I am not trying to make you feel bad or anything. You just need to change and improve some skills of your presenting.
Well, okay, Olivia, Cheer Ling, Hugh and Alan. At least you all know what I'm trying to show off myself. It's just I ordered KFC from Just Eat in November of 2018. I ordered the boneless bucket meal for myself until I didn't realize that my home address wasn't 100% correct. I tried to change the information but Just Eat refused to let me because they think I was a hacker plus a scammer for some reason. I was forced to pay still, never got my refund back, and they also deleted my account and taken my £40.44 of my Just Eat account money. I even tried to create a new account but Just Eat recognized me too much and I'll never use Just Eat ever again for the rest of my life. I think Just Eat is a scam company that takes your money away without realizing. It's like the adverts on your computer when you can win an iPhone or £100 for free. Those are scammers definitely.
Excuse me. Am I interrupting?
Not at all. Who are you?
I am Beth Bumblyhug. I am a new employee for Paul Perkinson, who is your manager. What are your names, the five of you?
I am Olivia Lockwell.
I am Chialing Helipunter.
I am Hugh Jackson.
I'm Alan Burberton.
And I am Prashant Kanshan. Pleased to meet you, Beth Bumblyhug.
Nice to meet you, Olivia, Chialing, Hugh, Alan and Prashant. I had to fill in extra forms to get into this job because I originally came from the United States of America. Getting through the UK border wasn't too tricky for me. I originally came from Northampton when I first lived in the UK in 2014. Live in England seems to be better than in the States, in my opinion.
Well, Beth, Chia Ling came from China, Alan came from Australia, and Prashant has originally came from India. England is not only an English country, but also international too, with so many people from around the world. Paul Perkinson is originally from Canada. Hugh and myself are the only employees here from the UK.
Tell us about yourself, Beth, and then we can share our stories from our childhood one at a time.
Big, slow, sigh. Am I ever going to be rescued or going back home at any time? Does nobody care or love about me? I guess I am an ugly joke to most people. Bigger, slow, sigh. I miss doing adverts. I miss Louis Jiggle. I miss presenting Shifu songs, Shiman, Jeffu, Herifu, Child Giraffu, Jirashi, Coronafu, Bleaking Beach Branch, Direct Daniel, Shifu Songs Christmas Edition 2020, Daniel Divin, and I even miss Oliver.
Good morning, Daniel. Are you ready for harder work than ever before?
We are not finished with you yet, Daniel. We know that you absolutely love this place. You love us like your own children, and you never, ever want to go back to planet Earth.
So just face it, Daniel. You will be staying with us forever, and you may as well forget about going back home. Get to the use of it.
But guys, I am seriously starting to feel homesick. Life for myself is not the same without being around with millions of people in the UK. I have tried my hardest to make the three of you happy, and you all still refuse to take me back home. I do not know what else I can do to get back home. I honestly bloody give up at this point.
Well, that's a good thing. Now you can enjoy life with the three of us, and we will treat you like a teddy bear. We pinky promise.
So come on now, Daniel. You know you got some serious work to do. Get to it.
At least there's one thing you do not have to put with anymore. The coronavirus. It's only on planet Earth. That's the reason why we will not take you back home until COVID is permanently gone forever. That's also the only reason we will take you back home. But I doubt that'll ever happen, because COVID will last forever on that piece of turd everyone is living in. So you may as well live here from now on and shut up silently for the remaining of your life.
But guys, I don't care about the bloody coronavirus. I don't care about the realities of the world. I just want to go back home so I can have a job and live. I regret being fired from Paul Perkinson, who sacked me months ago. Louis Teagle is my best friend, as he let me live at his house until that stupid pathetic alien taken me away from the spare room near around Christmas time. I missed Santa Claus coming to town, the Valentine's Day festival of 2021, my birthday that was in March, and I feel like my death is just around the corner. Big, slow, sigh. I am trapped forever. Alone, and far away.
So, you do not care about the coronavirus? Well, we will only let you go back home. If you can figure it out for yourself, we will not help or stop you. This spaceship is the only area in space to have oxygen. If you go out there and trying to reach planet Earth, you could die likely and highly.
So you may as well forget about it, Daniel. You are stuck here forever and ever. Come on now, start working by cleaning the floors with the toothbrush again.
Yeah, Daniel. And afterwards, you must clean the windows with your spit, wash our bodies with special robotic water, and make our dinner for 5 o'clock perfectly and accurately. Come on now, Solider. Put your back into it.
Big, slow, disappointing, sigh. Yes, you three. I'll be ready with those chores. God damn it. What on earth am I going to get back home from this dirty, horrible, nasty place hole? HMM. I need to make a spaceship. Wait a minute. This spaceship would do. All I have to do is drive it without those three bloody annoying monsters noticing. Perfect. Oh, you all regret meeting me, you three. Ha 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 ha